Hello, Fairfax County Public Schools. It's another day in schools. We're here with Cindy Conley from Irving Middle School. And a real fascinating thing that you're doing around Portrait of a Graduate, where you're having like a ComicCon.
So this is our second year doing the ComicCon. Katie Richter, one of our 8th grade science teachers, created it. It's a project-based learning unit for our science classes. Okay. And they create supervillains to use specific science powers to take out a superhero.
Well, I know superheroes are all the rage right now. Lots of people seeing Avengers Endgame and superpowers, and now you're able to take something around superheroes and apply it to science, which is an area where we really are, particularly in elementary and middle school, trying to get kids interested in STEM and STEM-related fields.
Absolutely. So the students also had to do research. They had to work collaboratively with a partner. They're working on communication skills.
And that's all that Portrait of a Graduate, beyond simple understanding information. How do you work in a team to present it, to communicate it, and maybe come up with a creative way? Maybe there's some powers or principles in science that we've never thought about giving a superhero, which will be interesting to see as we go see what these kids are up to.
Absolutely.
Work.
And Kree was most recently featured in Captain Marvel,
yes.
Got it.
So while in exile, he built himself a particle accelerator in which he would fire a proton beam at atomic nuclei to produce neutral pions, which would then decay into gamma rays.
Neutral
pions.
And pions, are they a real thing in science?
They are.
And do they really decay into gamma rays?
They do.
Okay.
This is a model of neutral pion decay.
Okay. So you've taken, Thomas, your existing knowledge of science, studied a little bit of the Marvel Universe,
yeah,
and merged this to create a villain.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Congratulations. Great job, Thomas.
So we're focused here in Irving Portrait of a Graduate on Communicator. So
okay,
we wanted to take what is a kind of a small lab in our 8th grade curriculum and really dive into it and give the students an opportunity to connect it to pop culture, to the real world and how they can see it play out, and just also allow some creativity. So they were charged with creating a supervillain who could defeat one or more of the Avengers using portions of the electromagnetic spectrum. So they could use gamma rays, they could use x-rays, ultraviolet, or they could just use regular visible light and change it by refracting it, reflecting it.
It's harmful for Avengers that use electronics in their weapons or suits, such as Iron Man.
Can we currently capture electronic magnetic waves and send magnetic pulses like that in real life today, or is that still just an idea you two have?
Yes, we can actually. There have been several accounts of other countries trying to use them against other countries in warfare.
Really?
And crippling weapons development and manufacturing facilities.
Oh, wow. So you've taken that idea and then put it in a super villain who can kind of mobile go anywhere and do that.
Yes.
So they're really using their knowledge of the electromagnetic spectrum,
mm-hmm,
and embedding something in that in a supervillain.
Exactly.
And I assume, is Marvel Comics sponsoring Irving Middle School with a major grant for learning?
I'm pretty sure that must be happening soon.
Okay.
I will say, though, to make it real, I do have friends who are in DC Comics and Marvel very high up. So the winning project from each class, actually, I do send to them, and they give feedback to the students. They talk to them about the project.
Oh, that is so cool. Yeah. That's cool. Well, we'll be looking for Tony Stark to come out here and support Irving Middle School in the fall.
Exactly.
Thanks for doing so much work to support Portrait of a Graduate here in Fairfax County Public Schools.
Thanks.